प्रेम सबूलो श्री गुरु महाराज की जय हो जय सीताराम देरी भोटी स्वागतम वेलकम बैक टू सूर्योदय ये थर्सडे मॉर्निंग साइमोकास्ट ऑन रेडियो एंड टीवी जागृति विद योर श्रुली पंडित शिव जनक महाराज ब्यूटीफुल डे इट इज हियर इन द रिपब्लिक ऑफ त्रिनिदाद एंड टोबैगो एज द सेलिब्रेशंस कंटिन्यू यस वी आर Now, today is the last day of the first of the Chaturmas that we spoke about. Those of you who missed our program on Chaturmas, please go back to our Sooryoday YouTube channel and view that program on the auspiciousness of this period known as Chaturmas. And the first month, it comes to an end today, dear devotees. This Purnima in the month of Shravan that ends the first month of the month of those that Chaturmas. Mass, most auspicious time where we have so many festivals that we celebrate in this period. And what we had the celebrations beginning yesterday, dear devotees, with the Shravani Upakarma. That Shravani Upakarma that took place on Radio and TV Jaagriti, you are well aware of, at Mayaro Manzilena there, where so many pundits of the SDMS, the Sanatan Dharma Mahasabha, met together and had that ceremony. And a fact is that this is the largest gathering of pundits that perform this ceremony outside of India. And congratulations to all those who of the Eastern Regional of committee of the SDMS who made all those preparations and had that celebration, dear devotees. In that ceremony, you would have heard and would see that the pundits themselves, dear devotees, who over the year would have been, you know, collecting all your negativities, you see, dear devotees. What happens when you bow to a pundit? What happens is that his positive energies through his sadhana will transfer to you, and your negative energies will transfer to him. And because of that, the pundits now have to go through a purification ceremony that will help them to get rid and negate those negativities which they have gathered from all the devotees which would have touch their feet or take their darshan during that year. And so we would have had the different snans of the various items, and also the bath in the sea, as well as the chanting of all those mantras as part of that rejuvenation of the energy that the pundits will now are fully charged to serve the communities. And that took place yesterday, dear devotees, because of the astrological factors that made yesterday the most appropriate day to have that ceremony. Likewise, dear devotees, today is another many observances, one of them of which we'll speak a little more of after this selection, which will give us a hint. Prim Sabolo Shri Gayatri Mata Ki Jai Ho. Sabolo Shri Gayatri Mata Ki Jai Ho. Jai Sitaram Dear Devotees, Swagatam. Welcome back to Sooryoday, your Thursday morning simulcast on Radio and TV Jaagriti with your Shri Pandit Shiva Janak Maharaj. Of course, if you look at your calendar today, you see many, many observances, and one of them, the greatest one, in my view, is that of Shri Gayatri Mata Jayanti. Yes, devotees, the manifestation of that form of Gayatri Mata. And Gayatri Mata, dear devotees, as we should all know by now, is the universal energy that prevails each and everything in this world, dear devotees. According to Devi Bhagavatam, dear devotees, when Lord Brahma, he created this earth, it wasn't alive. It was, something was missing. It was like plastic. It was like toys, you know, that when you have a toy farm and everything was just there, but only with the blessings of Gayatri Mata that everything became alive, dear devotees. And this is the greatness of Sri Gayatri Mata. And today is that Jayanti, as we all know by now, does not mean physical birth. It does not mean being born as a baby. It refers to Jayati Asti, or taking that manifested form, taking a manifested form, dear devotees. And so, dear devotees, Gayatri Mata, the importance of Gayatri Mata, and especially Gayatri Mantra. You see, yesterday, we would have had the Shravani Upakarma, as we mentioned before, by the pandits of the Sanatan Dharma Mahasabha. And in that ceremony, we would have chanted the Gayatri many times in Dhyan, in meditation, for purification, and also, you know, under the water as well, we would have chanted Gayatri Mantra many times. But Gayatri Mantra, devotees, has that potency to help each and every one of us. And this is what it says about the greatness of Gayatri Mata for each and every one of us. Gayatri is Veda Mata. She's the mother of the Vedas. A person totally devoted to Gayatri recitation can achieve great success in the path of self-achievement. Gayatri Mata inspires man towards righteous wisdom. An astral conscious electric current flows constantly in a person who is able to establish a relationship with Gayatri Mata, as she influences their mind, intellect, heart, and inner self. If no sooner the divine light of Gayatri dawns on the intellect feel of a person, the darkness of all evil thoughts, false convictions, degrading vices start dispelling. Gayatri undoubtedly and miraculously transformed the mental framework of a person to a systematic, healthy, religious, and balanced personality. This is the greatness of Gayatri Mantra, devotees, and Gayatri Mata. The well-developed mind produces thoughts leading to actions resulting in happiness. His work becomes excellent, and his well-intentioned thoughts radiate happiness, contentment, and peace. Principle Shri Gayatri Mata Ki Jai. This is the blessings of Gayatri Mata. Today is Gayatri Mata Jayanti, dear devotees, as we enjoy that selection that we had. Today is also another well-known celebration that is being advertised everywhere, dear devotees. What occasion is this? Let us learn from this selection. Prem Sabolo Shri Gayatri Mata Ki Jai, Shri Vishnu Bhagwan Ki Jai. Shri Vishnu Bhagwan Ki Jai Ho. Jai Sitaram, dear devotees, swagatam. Welcome back to Sooryoday with your Shri Shiva Janak Maharaj. And thus far we are discussing all the celebrations being celebrated today, dear devotees, being observed today. And thus far we have discussed that of the Shravani Upakarma, which happened yesterday, dear devotees, with the Sanatan Dharma Mahasabha Pandits. And we have discussed the greatness of Gayatri Mata and Gayatri Mantra in influencing your mind to achieve and to be the best that you can be physically and spiritually, dear devotees. Now, that last selection that we heard there, it is Raksha Bandhan, dear devotees. Raksha Bandhan. This is the bond of protection, dear devotees. And this is the most famous of all the celebrations today because of the commercial value of it for others, dear devotees. And we see so many ads and so many, you know, specials and so many different varieties of rakshas that are used, and it is used mostly for brothers and sisters. It's a brother and sister day, and nothing is wrong in that, and it's quite correct actually. However, it can also be used husband and wife day. It can also be used as a guru and shiksha day, where they tie that raksha bandhan, or that bond of protection, for gurus for their shikshas, wives for their husbands, and also for brothers to sisters. One such katha that directly relates from the Vishnu Puran, their devotees, to raksha bandhan as a brother and sister celebration, or even adopted brother, that we have so many people, you know, and this is something missing in society, that if you tie this raksha, this bond of protection, and sisters pray for their adopted brothers and other men in the community, that they have that respect for them, and they also help protect them and not hurt them or degrade them in any way, their devotees. However, if we go back to the Vishnu Puran, and it tells of a katha of the time of Raja Bali, their devotees, and that's a circumstance, those who missed the katha of the Chaturmas, this 4 months, on the last Sooryoday, or about 2 Sooryodays before, you can go back on our YouTube channel and look at that Chaturmas discourse that we had, Dear Devotees program in here on Sooryoday, and see the whole katha of Raja Bali. However, in the Vishnu Puran, there's a slight twist or aside because of every yug where the situations happen a little differently, Dear Devotees, and each Puranas will tell it in a different way. In the Vishnu Puran, it tells of when Raja Bali asked for the foot of Vaman Devta to be put on his head, and he went on to Patal Lok, their devotees, to the Neverlands. And there, Bhagwan Sri Vishnu said he will protect him, and he went to protect him as a Dwarpal, as a doorkeeper in his kingdom, their devotees. And Lakshmi Mata in Swarlok, missing her Dharampati, their devotees, she decided she will go to Patal, she will go to Raja Bali, she will get back her husband. And what she did, their devotees, she disguised herself as an old lady. She went to Raja Bali and she told him, as a king, I am an old lady, my husband has gone away for a while and I need somewhere to stay. And their devotees, she convinced, or Raja Bali accepted, that she can stay here with him, their devotees, and she treated him like a brother, their devotees. Likewise, he treated her like a sister. And when the Shravan Purnima came, their devotees, it is stated in the Vishnu Puran, when the Shravan Purnima came, she tied a raksha and she prayed for his protection as a good king. And as the custom is, their devotees, as we all know, that when we tie the raksha, that we pray for the protection of the person that you're tying the raksha on, and as well, the person who gets the raksha, they are obligated to give a gift to that person who tied the raksha. And so, having that brotherly and sisterly love for each other, Lakshmi Mata in disguise tying the raksha for Raja Bali, and Raja Bali now in turn asks her, tell me what you want, I will give you what you want. And then, dear devotees, Lakshmi Mata, she took her real form of Lakshmi Devi and she told Raja Bali, all I want is my husband, he is here with you protecting you, and I want him to come back home with me. Raja Bali, dear devotees, in the Vishnu Puran says that he allowed Bhagwan Sri Vishnu and Lakshmi Mata to go to Swarlok, but he made them promise to come and spend some time with him every so often, and that's the Chaturmas period, their devotees, according to our scriptures, that Bhagwan Sri Vishnu and Lakshmi Mata both visit that of Raja Bali, their devotees. And this occasion starts, or could be considered, the very first raksha between a brother, adopted brother, a considered brother, and a sister, dear devotees. This video that I want to share with you, those who TV Jaagriti, I hope you, it brought it really is, you can see, you will see why I'm acting this way. The symbolism of true brother and sister, how we should tie our rakhis, dear devotees. Prem se bolo Shri Vishnu Bhagwan ki jai, Shri Lakshmi Mata ki jai ho. Prem se bolo Shri Vishnu Bhagwan ki jai, Shri Lakshmi Mata ki jai, Shri Bali Maharaj ki jai ho. Jai Sitaram, dear devotees, swagatam. Welcome back to Sooryoday, and I'm hoping that really touched your heart. For those who are on Radio Jaagriti and those of you in on YouTube, dear devotees, the recording of this program, dear devotees, in that it had, you know, we complain so much sometimes, and we find so many reasons to not love our brothers or sisters. In that video, dear devotees, there was a girl, a sister with no hands. And with her feet, dear devotees, she put the chandan, she did the aarti, she tied the raksha on her brother's hand, dear devotees, showing the true love and meaning of this raksha bandhan, dear devotees, to build communities, to build brotherly and sisterly love in our society, dear devotees. And so the katha of Raja Bali, dear devotees, and Lakshmi Mata tying that raksha from the Vishnu Puran, it gives that symbolism of what siblings should have, that love for each other. It says here that it reflects on the pure bond of Rakhi or Raksha, which is full of love, compassion, trust, faith, and loyalty that brothers and sisters should have for each other. And dear devotees, in fact, this katha has some value to it in that the mantra or the shloka that is chanted during the time of the raksha happens to bring that of which blessings of prosperity and wealth and protection and happiness and everything that Lakshmi Mata brings to you, just as she brought to Raja Bali, she brings to you. Let's listen to this mantra, dear devotees. Prim sabolo Shri Lakshmi Mata ki jai, Shri Raja Bali Maharaj ki jai ho. Prim sabolo Shri Lakshmi Mata ki jai, Shri Raja Bali Maharaj ki jai ho. Jai Sitaram, dear devotees, swagatam, welcome back to Sooryoday with your Shri Pandit Shiva Janak Maharaj. And in that shloka, dear devotees, that is chanted during the time of the raksha, reminds us of the katha that we learnt of this morning from the Vishnu Puran, when Lakshmi Mata tied a raksha for the protection of Raja Bali. And it says here, dear devotees, the meaning of this mantra, it says, I am tying a raksha to you, similar to the one tied on Raja Bali, the powerful king of demons. O Raksha, be firm and do not waver in your blessings, dear devotees, in the blessings of protection, in the blessings of prosperity and wealth and happiness, all those things that Lakshmi Mata brought to Raja Bali, dear devotees. And dear devotees, may that go to all brothers and sisters, guru, shikshas, wives, husband, all of those tying that raksha today, chanting the mantra, dear devotees. You can get it on YouTube, dear devotees, where it's called the Raksha Sutra, the Raksha Sutra, the Bali Raksha Sutra, dear devotees, which is the mantra or the sutra that is chanted when you tie the raksha. May the blessings of Mata Lakshmi be on you, just as she blessed Raja Bali, their devotees. And as we celebrated last night at the current Saraswati Lakshmi Mandir there with Pandit Surendra and others in the Southland, our very first time visiting there. Very beautiful mandir it is, and lots of hospitality as well, just as Panditji extends on other occasions as well in other institutes. And so it's a beautiful mandir you all should visit sometime. Dear devotees, next week Thursday will be Shri Krishna Janam Jayanti. And Jayanti, dear devotees, we'll discuss next week programming. However, you all are invited to join me, Pandit Shiva Janak Maharaj, at the Amar Jod Krishna Mandir, dear devotees, where we begin puja at 8 p.m. sharp, dear devotees. And you are invited to bring along a little baby Bal Krishna form, dear devotees, and thali and puja materials, where we will be doing individual pujas, dear devotees. I'll chant the mantras and you and your family will sit and perform puja to Krishnaji, dear devotees. That starts it from 8 p.m. And kathas and pravachans and offerings. We have offerings at around 9 for those who need to leave early for whatever reason. And we continue pravachan and singing and so forth until the midnight hour, where we will celebrate the Palna Puja in full, dear devotees. So you all are invited for that. It's at the Amar Jod Krishna Mandir on the compound of the Five Rivers Hindu School. Lots of parking, lots of security. You're very safe. Come out and pray with all your heart. Bhagwan Shri Krishna will bless you. And devotees, also in the celebration of Shri Krishna Janam, all week, that week, we'll have discourses being done from the Bhagavat Mahapuran, dear devotees, at the Karapu Shiv Mandir. So you all are invited there. On the day after the Krishna Janam, next week, on the Friday, the 23rd, you all can join me, Pandit Shiva Janak Maharaj. I'll be officiating and doing the pravachan for the Bhagavad Katha at the Karapur Shiv Mandir there, devotees. So please come along. It's right behind the racetrack there in Arima. Just follow the road. And of course, you can't miss the Mandir. That will be so beautifully decorated. So there, devotees, until we meet again, we pray, Om Asatoma Sadgamaya Tamasoma Jyotirgamaya Mrityorama Amritam Gamaya Om Shanti, 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 Harihi Om.